Before this video starts, I want to state that I do not offer spiritual services for court case matters. This video is purely for educational purposes. Now, also, I want you guys to understand something. Facebook, YouTube does not sponsor me. I don't get paid from social media. Whatever revenues I gain is through my clients and my business. But bottom-wise of production-wise, I give you a lot of quality videos. I've invested into cameras, you know, to give you good quality content. All I'm asking you guys is to donate to the channel because this keeps me motivated. It keeps me making videos, you know. So listen, the Cash App is going to be in the title as well as in the description. So therefore, you know, listen, those little $5, $10, they go very far. You know, it just pushes me and motivates me to give you better content. And it keeps me on the internet, you know? So I don't have to be working a dead-end job or 9-to-5. So listen, tune in, continue watching the video. I hope you guys get a lot of inspiration from this. And I hope this video allows you to see things a little clearer. With that said, let's get to the video.
Let me tell you what it's like. I'm gonna tell you what it's like. Let me tell you what it's like. Fighting 40 for the life. In a room with a hype boy, nigga, you don't like. When you seen your homie, first thing that he gave you was a knife. Tryna tell you that it's real. You don't know how I feel. When you lose that appeal, it's like speeding down a hill. And your brakes don't work, pray to God that he take that wheel. You don't know how I go. You hope the witness don't show. Court days coming slow, baby mama, she a hoe. And I'm still sliding, tryna find out who killed four. Boy, this shit ain't no joke. And I know this for sure. Cause the judge burst off of 54. Boy, he think you a hoe. Tell your lawyer, let's go. Suit up, nigga, it's time for war. Let me tell you what it's like. 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 Let me tell you what it's like.
So, you want to utilize voodoo to beat your case. I want to talk to you guys today and give you some real life experience to guide you on your path. See, I want to say this, is that human beings are just human beings. You got to put the spirit before human beings. I don't care if you have a lawyer. This lawyer can have great credentials. But if the spirit says no, it's not going to go through. If it's not in the divine will, if it's not in written for you to win that case, you're not going to win that case. So I want you people out there that's facing criminal charges to take your trust away from man and put it in the higher power. Whatever the name you use to describe the higher power, so be it. But listen, so many people, they're let down when they go to court. They're facing these charges and their lawyer doesn't help them. Sometimes it seems as though your lawyer is trying to screw you over. Now, I'm not saying that I have a great lengthy rap sheet, but I've been in certain scenarios in my past and I felt as though the lawyer was trying to screw me. And you have a lot of people that have serious cases, serious charges that go up to that they have cases pending against them, and they put their trust in the lawyer, and then they only realize whether it's a public defender or it's their own personal lawyer, they feel as though the lawyer is trying to screw them over. In a case like this, I have to mention the scripture. It says, Lord, I know it's not in man to direct his own steps. See, if the scripture is telling you it's not in man to direct his own steps, it's already telling you that you got to put your faith and trust in a higher power. Listen, I'm going to give you some scenarios, some stories, and I'm going to talk about the outcome of workings, you know, that may transpire or that have transpired in different cases that I've seen through over the years. And I'm gonna give you my breakdown and elaboration of what I think of utilizing spell work or utilizing voodoo, the spirit. to help you in your matters. This here was nothing but divine. This was a while back. This is early 2000s. There was a person that I aided. There was a person that had problems and I aided them. They were facing assault with a deadly weapon, and they had a couple of other charges whatsoever pending against them. Now, again, this is not to boast and say that I'm divine. I'm not. I'm just a human being that understands that there's something greater than me. This individual came to me with a case, and I said, listen, this is way before I even got hit to, this is way before I really became experienced or to the age that I am now. I would say this is roughly probably 15 years ago. This person came to me with the case and I said, let's try this. So I did whatever ritual I need to do. The day of the case, we go in to see the judge. Now, prior to this, this person was going to the court, to the court back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Now, when this person came to me, we went to court. And as we went to the courtroom, we were looking for the person who filed the charges against, you know, my client. When I say client, you know, basically, they hired me to do spiritual work for them. And as we're sitting in the court, we're looking at, you know, the person who put the charges out there. This person was nowhere to be found. So now we're sitting in there. It's our time to go up. So what happens when our time goes up, the judge asks, where's the plaintiff, right? The plaintiff was nowhere to be found. So the judge drops all the charges. Now here goes a crazy fucking thing. The plaintiff, the person who filed the charges, who had the charges against my client at the moment, at that time, excuse me. She was standing outside smoking a cigarette. She was standing outside smoking a cigarette. We just walked through the door after the charges were dropped. We walked through the door, and here she goes standing outside, and she looks, she makes a double take while she's smoking cigarettes. She makes a double take. She's like, huh? And she puts out a cigarette. And as we're walking down, she runs back inside. So we don't know what happened after that. All we know is that the charges were dropped. And we went about our merry way. That was nothing but God. That was nothing more than the Spirit. That person was smoking a cigarette outside. And here we go walking through the door like, hey, now have a nice day. The charges got dropped. Now, there was another scenario I'm going to give you. This was another case. This person, her boyfriend, her baby father at the time, her baby father at the time was facing attempted murder. They had him on camera. Now, this lady was dealing with a mumbo in New York. This lady was screwing her for about 2 years. Here goes this voodoo priestess. This voodoo priestess, you know, singing all these voodoo songs and all this other type of shit, straight from Haiti, speaking Creole, this and that, blah, 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 talking all this blah, blah, blah shit. You know, mambo, this and that, I saw where all this fuckery, this and that. Shaking her ass on, all this fucking religious bullshit. She was sucking that client dry. Now, the client said she was tired. I didn't know this lady from a can of paint. So she came to me with that situation. And when she came to me, I was like, if I'm just trying to recollect my thoughts from the past. When she came to me, it was like a week before court. I was like, I don't know if this is gonna work. I don't know. Mm-hmm. I charged her. 1 second. I charged this client close to nothing. I charged this client close to nothing. I said, listen. I wouldn't say nothing. I mean, to a lot of people, I'm going to be honest with you. I charged the client $700. You know, this is way back in the day whatsoever. Nothing that I would even charge today. Not, and again, I want to stress this as I stated before the video. I do not do court case work today. I charged her $700. I said, listen, because it's so close to our court date, listen, if it doesn't work, I'll just give you your money back. I wasn't sure of it myself. You know, and this is what I want to say to people. When you humble yourself, you know, as the scripture says, he who exalts himself shall be abased. If you exalt yourself, you will be abased. You will be made to look like a fool. Because when you step up and say, oh, you know, I can do this, I can do that, that's when God proves you wrong. That's when the Spirit proves you wrong. So I humbled myself. I said, listen, I don't know if this is going to work because this is last minute and you're asking me to do something for you. I'll try my best. If I can't do it, I'll just give you all your money back, all right? So all of a sudden, okay, she goes to court. She calls me and says, oh my God. Oh my God, Leonard. They're offering a probation. She said, they're offering a probation before I did work. This guy was in about 2 to 3 years in limbo. There was no probation, nothing thrown up. They said either you beat the case or you go to prison or jail, one of those. Nothing. So she calls me up and she says, what do you need me to do, Leonard? What do you need me to do? What should I tell him to do? Listen, he didn't have probation and now he has probation. You better tell that motherfucker to take the probation. This guy wanted to beat the case. So after arguing, after his child's mother argued with him, he actually, you know, took the, she actually convinced him to take the probation. Now, I'm going to give you another story. This story was a probation officer. Well, I helped this person become a probation officer. This person was trying out and I gave them a lot of things to get them on. But she had a situation, a court situation, and she was just getting screwed over. And she found me somehow. When we went to work, I told her that, listen, when we're doing this, it can either end up with the time being lessened, the charge being dropped, or probation. Those are typically what you'll find in court case situations when you're doing magi or you're getting spirits involved to aid you. Now, mind you, this guy was facing human trafficking, pandering, things of that nature. He was facing some serious charges. He was looking at 20 something years. And his case was rock solid. You beat this case, whatever. You're not looking at any light time here. It's either you beat the case or you're going to prison. So mind you, excuse me if I pause for a moment because I'm trying to remember. I'm going back in my mind to give you some accurate information because I don't want to just tell you random stuff or make certain things up. He was looking at 20 something years. And when I came into play, there was one day they finally broke and said to him, You already got 2 years in. Now, mind you, there was no offers at all, period, you know? He wasn't trying to break. He wasn't trying to give in. So as I did the work, they came to him with an offer of 3 years from 20. They said, listen, you already did 2 years. You give us 3 more years and, you know, we'll let you go. Now, mind you, this is where people will be like, you know, what should I do here? Now, mind you, you never had this offer before. Now you get an offer. All you just got to do is just give him 3 years. I know it sucks to give him 3 more years of your time. I know it sucks, but 3 more years of your time is better than 20 years of your time. So I tell the client, tell him to take the 3 years. I know it sounds crazy, but tell him to take the 3 years. He chose not to. He chose to fight it. And I told her, listen, I can't guarantee you anything after this, because this right here is if he basically fucks this up, to me, I felt as though this was the best the spirit could do. And he chose not to go with it. He chose to fight it. And you know what happened? He lost the case and ended up with 20 something years behind bars. It's a lot to think about. A lot to think about. A lot to think about. I'm going to give you another story. Now, mind you, this is a story of a client. This is years ago. I remember, and this is going to be me being honest, you know, this is like years ago, and I fucked this job up. I remember this client came to me. She said her boyfriend was behind bars, and he was basically had some people that testified against him. I think he was facing murder or something like that. Something on that line, right? Something on that line. And I remember the people that testified against him, months as he was working, they had to go to court and something like that. Now, the person didn't show up, right? Now, they didn't show up. I'm just going back in my memory for a second. Just give me a second for you guys watching. They went back to court, and the people that the witnesses that were supposed to show, they did not show. Now, mind you, the crazy thing is before we went to court, I remember where I had my altar at that I was doing work for this guy. I remember next to that, the spirit's altar, the spirit that I was working with for that case, court case, there was a rat that died next to the altar. Now, for me, that was a sign saying that if that rat was dead, I know people be like, yo, what the fuck? You had a rat in your house? Yeah, well, I used to live in a fucking fucked up house. You know, before I became successful, I used to live in a fucked up house, rats eating my shit. Yeah, shit like that happens. So anyhow, the rat was dead out of nowhere. Never seen a dead rat in the basement whatsoever. It was dead right in front of the altar that I was working at. So I put two and two together and I said to myself, oh shit, that's a sign. A rat. What is a rat? A snitch. That snitch didn't show up to court. So I'm thinking everything is good and Gucci, everything. I'm ready to, you know, throw up the gloves and be like, yeah, whatever, you know what I'm saying? So now here goes, I start feeling myself. Instead of letting the job play out, I figured I'm gonna take this altar, move it upstairs and put it in a room, just, you know, put it in another room. I did not know that the spirits, the altar that I moved was too close to another altar. And for those of you that are in Santeria, you know that Shango and Ogun cannot be together. So the same thing applies to this spirit here, where I moved the spirit's altar, which is gonna remain anonymous because the game is supposed to be sold and never told. I moved the altar of that spirit into the room with other spirits. Come to find out, they started beefing. They started fighting. And what ended up happening? About a couple of weeks later, Some shit happens, they bring in a new witness, and my client's lover got screwed. Fucked him up in the system. And that was a case that really affected me. Like, seriously. Because it leads me to say this, is that when you're dealing with a spiritual worker, to help you out with a court case, they got to be on point. They can't be a person that's willy-nilly fucking around doing dumb shit. You're playing with your fucking life. When a spirit, you can't just let any old person work on your case, because that case can turn from a small situation and turn into something disastrous. There's a lot of things that can go wrong in court case work. It is a job of precision. You need someone that has a clear mind. A person that's not getting fucked up on drugs. A person that don't give a fuck. This person has to be sincere. You can't just deal with somebody that's just about the money, just about the money. They got to be sincere. This person has to be someone that cares about you. Because if they're just after the money, they can give a fuck less if you end up with fucking 20 to 50 years. Listen. In the midst of this, some people say, which one is better than going with a lawyer or going with a spiritualist? I would say go with both. Because when you have the spirit backing the human movements or human interaction, it is as though that the spirit is compelling the person to make the right moves, if it's done correctly. But now, if the human is not doing what they're supposed to, you left kind of in the hands of fate. Your lawyer at times can be a public pretender. And for those of you that do not know what a public pretender is someone that does not have your interests in mind. Someone that doesn't care about you and when they're trying to resolve your court situation. And sometimes they're working with the district attorney that basically has charges against you. Sometimes they're working with the judge to screw you over. In a situation like this, this is a situation where you better pray to God. You better pray to your ancestors or your ancestors. Because sometimes, you know, the flesh is weak. The flesh is weak. Again, I've had a lawyer once screw me over. And if it wasn't for me praying for wisdom, praying for divine guidance, I would not see that this lawyer was trying to screw me over. After I paid that lawyer about $5,000 to $6,000 for this service. So what I'm saying to you people is this. Don't put your trust wholeheartedly in man. Of course, do your diligent research when you're searching out a lawyer. But also, if you're going to go the spiritual route, make sure you do your diligent research on that spiritualist. Look up their credentials. Because the last thing you need is a lawyer that's not working and a spiritualist that's not working. Now, I would prefer, if I were you, to get a good lawyer and just go about it naturally. But if you're going to go about it spiritually, understand the risks that are involved. I think I said everything that I needed to. I thank you guys for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe.